class, I am going to explain to you about probability. How we can define the probability. Introduction to probability. This is chance of occurrence. Basically, probability means chance of occurrence. It may happen or may not be happen. The theory of probability came into the existence in 17th century in France. Two scientists were there, Pascal and Fermat. They introduced this probability in the games while doing the gambling. Suppose, before going to the main definition of probability, we should have to learn some basic terminologies like as random experiment, sample space, equally likely events, mutually exhaustive events. First of all, I would like to start about the basic definition of experiment. I think everyone uses this term experiment, but how can you define this term experiment? Experiment is nothing but a physical action or process which can be observed and the result should be noted. Suppose, if you are tossing a coin, then we can see that observation, after that we will notice the result. What you will get the outcome as head or tail. In this experiments also we are having two types of experiments. They are deterministic experiments or predictable experiments and unpredictable experiments, or we can say that as random experiment. Deterministic experiment means before performing the experiments, you can predict the results. Suppose, we are going through a stone upside. Then we know that definitely it will fall down due to the gravitational force. That is the deterministic experiment, because we know the outcome before performing the experiment. Coming to the random experiment, here what happens is, we know the outcomes, but we can't predict the outcome. Suppose you are throwing a die. Then what are the possible outcomes? You may get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. But you can't predict that outcome, what it may be. So this is called a random experiment. That is the main term we will use here in our subject probability. We will use that in a random experiment. Right? But that is the basic term, random experiment. Next, event. When you are getting the outcomes, each outcome is called as an event. When you are tossing a coin, we are having two outcomes, head and tail. Each one is an event. Next, main definition is sample space. The set of all possible outcomes of an experiment is called a sample space. And we will denote it as S. If you are tossing a coin, then the sample space is consisting of two outcomes, head and tail. This is about the sample space. Next, we will see about the equally likely events. Equally likely events means both the events are having the same chance. Suppose you take the same example. Here I will define the event A as getting a head. Getting a head, and I will define event B as getting a tail. Okay. Then what is the chance of occurrence of the event A? This 50%. A fair coin is always having one head and a tail. So getting a tail is also we are having 50%. Then this sample space is consisting of two equally likely events. It is not necessary that each experiment is having equally likely events only. Sometimes you won't get equally likely events. Suppose we are having a bag with 6 blue balls and 4 red balls. Now I want to pick up a ball from that bag. I am defining an event is, whenever I am picking up a ball, it should be, what is the chance that it should be a blue color? Chance of getting a blue ball. And I am taking event B as chance of getting a red. red ball. So what is the chance of getting a blue ball now? We are having 6 blue balls. So definitely it should be 60% chance is there to get a blue ball and 40% chance is there to get a red ball. Here these two events are not equally likely events, but here in this case these are equally likely events. Then similarly we are having one more term named as mutually exclusive events. Mutually exclusive events means the happening of one event predict the happening or we reject the happening of the other event. When you are tossing a coin, you are getting a head. That means it rejects the happening of the tail. Okay, so these are mutually exclusive events, or you can say that the union of the two events, if you are getting the sample space, then it should be a, then the two events are mutually exclusive events. Now we will define our main definition of probability. Probability, first of all, they defined as a classical definition. These two scientists, Pascal and Fermat. To define this probability, they took some assumptions here. What are the assumptions are? The events should be finite. Whatever the events you are defining here, these should be finite. And that event should be equally likely events. At the beginning, classical definition of probability was defined under the two assumptions. They are, one is finite events, another is equally likely events. For that, they will define classical definition of probability. If you are performing a random experiment, then definitely you will get some outcomes. That set of outcomes we are saying as a sample space. Suppose in my experiment, I am getting n outcomes. Okay. Total sample space is consisting of n outcomes. My favorable event, I will take that event should be in the sample space. Why? Because sample space consisting of all the events. Now I will define one event. It should be in the sample space. That should be my favorable event. Then the chance of getting my favorable event is m outcomes. Then the probability is defined as p is equal to number of favorable cases divided by total number of exhaustive cases, or else I can say here m by n. Let us see one example. If I am taking one example as tossing two coins. In tossing two coins, sample space is consisting of, now we should have tried all the possible outcomes in the sample space. When you are tossing two coins, what are the outcomes? Is a chance of hitting two heads, head tails, tail head, tail tails. Now, what is the, my problem is, what is the probability of getting two heads? What is the probability of getting two heads? Regarding the definition, I need first of all number of favorable cases. And I am asking my event as getting two heads. How many favorable events are there here? Only one favorable event. So my m value is here 1. And in the probability definition, denominator is having total number of exhaustive events. How many cases are there? 4. So here my n value is nothing but 4. Then the probability of that particular event is 1 by 4. Right? So here, this is about the probability. See here, in the events also we will define, events also you can define as the two types of events. They are compound events. Compound events means which can be broken into, further into smaller events. Or elementary events. See here, elementary events. Events are again classified into two types. Event means one item you are defining from the sample space, right? Elementary events means which cannot be broken. Suppose you are throwing a die, then the sample space consisting of, when you are throwing a die, consisting of the events 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
am defining as getting a odd number. My event is here getting an odd number. Can you broken this one? Getting an odd number means when you are throwing a die, what are the chances to get an odd number here? You may get here 3, that is an odd number. You may get here 1, that is an odd number. You may get here 5. You are defining an event as getting an odd number, but there are 3 chances are there to get that event. So this is called the compound event. That means which can be again split into the part of the elementary events. Okay. So these are the 2 types of events, and this is the classical definition of probability. After that, again these 2 scientists are defined the axiomatic definition of probability without taking those 2 assumptions. What are the assumptions we took for the classical definition? That should be as the finite event should be there and equally likely event should be there. But for all the problems, it is not necessary. So again, they extended it to the axiomatic definition of probability. That we will continue in the next session.